everyone, this is Ricky Horton with Fabrication Information Systems. Wanted to do the second video in the 2020i beta. I'm going to go back into the drawing logs again and talk about something that I know a lot of you document control people will absolutely love. If you'll remember, in the current version, if you had a mistake in a rev, you had to go down through one by one to fix those mistakes in the rev. There was no global edit. Well, today, yes, we have a global edit of revisions, which is extremely nice now. You'll see right here in my drawing log that I've got some drawings here with a couple revisions. These have just rev one, and then these other ones have one and two. So let's say that rev one should have had a prior date, which of course seems to be the biggest issue when you have to go down through and you fix revs one by one, is the date is always the wrong date, it seems like, and then you have to fix them all and takes forever to do. So let's say that rev one should have been dated last Friday, which was 8/17 or something like that, 21, I don't know. So let's fix those. So I'm going to go down to global edit revisions, and you'll see I've got multiple options: update all revisions, update the latest revision, or update a particular rev number. I'll choose to update particular rev number. Let's say I want to update rev one, and we will date that, or excuse me, date revised. We will date that last Friday, 8/21, and go update. And yes, I do want to update. Notice that it only did one though. You'll see the one that I had selected, the date rev was 8/21. These rev ones didn't change. These rev ones did not change. What this actually does is it works like a global edit selected. So if I choose all of them and go global edit revisions and then update rev one, I'm gonna change that date revise now to 8/21, go update, yes. And now all of my rev ones are dated 8/21. So if I click on any of these, all of those are dated 8/21. So really, really nice. I can update those in a number of ways. Global edit, update all revisions, update latest revision, update rev one, unchange any of these files. Really, really nice. Another thing I want to point out too, though, is that you can now also delete revisions, which is really nice as well. I can delete the latest revision or delete a specific rev number. So I'm going to say that let's delete this rev two, delete revisions. I'm going to delete rev two and go delete. Yep. Notice it only does the one again, right? So that makes sense. Let's do our selecting all of them, go delete revisions, and I'll just do delete latest revision, go delete. Are you sure? Yes, I am. So notice that it did the latest of all the ones I had selected. So these all had the latest rev were rev one, so it deleted rev one. These, the latest rev were rev two, so it deleted rev two. So let me just do this again to get rid of all of them, delete latest rev, yep, and so now all my revs are gone. Really nice. Now you can global edit revisions. You can globally delete revisions. Will really be a huge time saver for a lot of you, I know. Let me know if you got any questions. Give me comments below. Let me know if you got questions, if you want to see something else. If you've got questions about what I just did, just let me know in the comments below. I'll also put a link down there for where you can download the beta version. Go download it, run it, let us know how it's running. We send that into Tekla support, let them know if you've got any suggestions on it. I'll also put a link down below to the first 2020i beta video as well. So give me your comments below. Thanks for watching.